You are welcome to Africa Uncovered YouTube channel. My name is DJ, and today we are going to be looking at something rather serious, on a serious note, okay? Namibia has rejected extension, visa extension for the King of Buganda, Ronald Mwenda Mutebi. Namibia has rejected visa extension for the King of Buganda, King Ronald Mwenda Mutebi. That is the story that we're going to be discussing today. So this is how we begin. For some time, the King of Buganda, Ronald Mwenda Mutebi, has been embattling some illness. The illness that has seen him go to a number of hospitals, him visiting different hospitals, including in Uganda, where he has received treatment in Uganda, but also abroad, including the UK. Now, in the recent months, it was reported that the King of Buganda, Ronald Mwenda Mutebi, was taken to Namibia to receive a treatment according to the advice of the doctors, who advised that he could take his treatment in a nearby country where they work in tandem. Okay, the hospital in which he was in the UK, where he was receiving his treatment, works in tandem with the hospital in Namibia. Therefore, the King of Buganda, Ronald Mwenda Mutebi, was taken to Namibia to receive his treatment, and he's been there for some time. But today, and not necessarily today, there's been a story circulating in media beginning yesterday and today, where they are saying that the Namibian government has refused to extend the extension of the Buganda King Ronald Mwenda Mutebi. The Namibian government has refused a request to extend the visa for the Ugandan king, who has been getting medical treatment in the country since April. King Mutebi, Ronald II of Buganda, has been receiving treatment for undisclosed condition. The center where he has been staying requested his visa extension earlier this month. But in response, the International Relations Ministry said Namibia immigration law provided for a maximum stay of only 90 days in a year for foreign citizens. This comes weeks after authorities reported expressed displeasure over protests by Ugandan activists at the Namibian diplomatic missions. The Ugandan envoy in South Africa said recently that Namibian authorities were unhappy with the harassment of their diplomatic officials regarding the king's stay. Now, this is where I want us to zero. The Ugandan envoy in South Africa said recently that the Namibian authorities were unhappy over the harassment of their diplomatic officials regarding the king's stay. Now, we all know that at one point, Ugandans went to the Namibian embassy in the diaspora and protested that the Kabaka of Buganda, Ronald Mwenda Mutebi, was in Namibia. To them, what they thought that the Kabaka was kidnapped in his stay in Namibia. However, the publications have been, the communications have been that the Kabaka has been receiving treatment. Now, all that tension that has been accumulating, you know, them, Namibia, the Ugandans having, you know, protested at the Namibian consul. And then a few weeks ago, there were a number of dignitaries from the Kingdom of Buganda who went to Namibia as well to check on the king. However, there were, you know, rumors circulating that these people were not even allowed as well to see the king. For the reasons we might not go there. Why they were not allowed, we might not go there. So you can see that there's been a bit of tension on the Namibian government that has been caused by all the stir around the king while he receives his treatment. So they, instead of them continuing to get all these raids and abuses and protests around their consuls in different countries, they have instead decided not to renew the visa of the King of Buganda. For them to, you know, to break even, they know, yes, it is going to kind of cause a diplomatic stir between Uganda and Namibia, but on their side, they want to believe that Uganda should be able to understand, among others, reasons why they have decided not to renew the visa of the king. So many people have been requesting for the return of the king in Uganda. So this could be a blessing in disguise. But is it advantageous to the health of the king? Because as we understand, the reason why they wanted his visa to be renewed was that such that the king could still be receiving treatment in Namibia, which seemed to be working. So the BBC article continues that in May, there were protests at the Namibian High Commission in UK with Ugandan demonstrators demanding transparency over the king's extended stay. They wanted Namibia to disclose information about the king's whereabouts to put to rest suspicion that he had been kidnapped. Okay, so people started saying the king has been kidnapped, why he overstayed in Namibia, because from UK they expected him to directly return to Uganda, but he didn't went to Namibia. So there were those suspicions, okay? So one of the reasons why people were demonstrating were that they wanted clarity about the whereabouts of the king. We continue. The Namibian government then referred the matter of Buganda tradition. The Namibian government then referred the matter to the Buganda traditional authorities. 2 weeks ago, Buganda traditional chiefs traveled to Namibia to seek the truth about the king's health, sparking diplomatic concerns and a rebuke from the Ugandan president, Yoweri Museveni. This is according to the BBC. Okay, I don't remember in any writing or video where the president was, you know, rebuking the traditional chiefs for having traveled to Namibia, when the story actually that we have on ground is that they were facilitated by the president. So I don't know why BBC is getting this kind of story. They quote, "I request all the Ugandans to stop embarrassing Uganda by opportunistically trying to show how much they are for the Kabaka," Mr. Museveni said. That is according to BBC. So the delegation, which was said to have traveled without the knowledge of either the Buganda Kingdom or the Ugandan authorities, was briefly detained and questioned by Namibian officials, who reportedly asked if they had authorization to see the monarch. Okay, so we remember those who were meant to be there for like 2-3 days ended up spending 2 weeks. There are rumors that actually they didn't see him. There were rumors that they were arrested and put in custody. So there are so many stories around that. So they had gone, even though the Buganda king had addressed his subject through the pre-recorded video where he spoke about his improving health and expressing hope that he would return soon. So the Buganda, the king had previously, you know, appeared in a video that also raised questions, because some people were saying it is fake, others were saying it is real, you know. So he had appeared in the video assuring people that he was improving and he would at one point return. But nevertheless, the delegation of the traditional chiefs did not take heed. They decided to travel to Namibia. The reason why they were stopped per se not to see him is not known. So on Wednesday, the Namibian newspaper quoted the state officials saying that it was normal practice for a foreigner national who had stayed for 90 days to return to their country. The 90 days that were given to the king had elapsed, and therefore they decided they are not going to renew his visa. Hence, very soon we are likely to see the king returning, regardless of whether he's okay or he has, you know, regained his good health or not. But because the country, the hosting country, has decided not to extend his visa, by all means, he will have to return. Unless if the government, if let's say the president of Uganda and the president of Namibia sit on a round table as presidents and decide to say, let's find ways of how we can neutralize this and ensure that the king stays. That is, if it's in the advantage, if it's advantageous for the king to stay. If it's not, then the king will be returning and it will be jubilations for those who have been requesting for his return. Okay? So there are two or three things that I was trying to look at in this story. One, sometimes we do things not knowing what they're going to lead to. People were demonstrating at different embassies of Namibia in different countries, putting them on pressure, telling them that their king, in this case, Ronald Mwenda Mutebi, was kidnapped in their country and they demanded to access to the king. Okay? So all that pressure that Namibia had has, you know, tantamounted to this decision that they have taken. So those unnecessary pressures that we sometimes put on things that we don't have, you know, we don't have whereabouts, that we don't know about, are sometimes really, really not important. Because now we don't know if the king is going to return because he's healthy, or he's going to be forced to return because his stay is due, because his days of stay in Namibia are over. You see? So people probably did not project to see this, whether it is going to come advantageous or disadvantageous. Well, there could be some people who will be happy about his return, but you don't know. The reason why they probably wanted his extension is that probably he was not ready to return. So sometimes when we're doing these things, let's try to think beyond and see, couldn't it be right that maybe the king wanted some privacy in, because that I want to believe that there are good hospitals in Uganda that could probably handle the king. So why did he decide to go to Namibia? There must have been a reason. Okay? There could have been another way of ensuring that they get to know if the king is well and is there, to remove all the doubts, than putting pressure on a foreign country, than putting pressure on a sovereign country of Namibia. So I thought that was important for us to discuss today on As a Matter of Fact. I hope we can learn a thing or two. If you think the story is interesting, or whatever we always give you here on our channel is interesting, please smash a like, share, comment, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Otherwise, from me to you, I am TJ. Adios.